about institutional problems, for instance, at university level. We'll be talking, for instance, about how universities are structured, for instance, to recognize that women may need particular kinds of support structures at particular life stages. What we see, for instance, if you've been an academic for any appreciable length of time, is that when you're teaching an undergraduate class, you tend to have parity. There are as many boys as there are girls, young men as there are young men as there are young women. But as they move to the graduate level, master's, MPhil, PhD, women begin to fall out. And they fall out for very simple reasons. The social reason, right? Which is, well, I'm 25, I'm 26, I may be very intelligent, might be interested in an academic career, but there's pressure from my mother, my father, my aunts, my friends, to hurry up and get married and pop out those babies, right? So you're torn between what you might want for yourself and what society expects of you. And that's what you see when, as an academic, you know, spotting really brilliant young women who then don't take up academic opportunities. So that's the big problem. But even when you have women who then cross that barrier, that very tension-filled barrier, we all go through it, right? And they get into the lecturer position, the problem then becomes, how do you manage your academic responsibilities and your increasing sort of lifetime responsibilities? And it's not just taking care of the children that you might have, or taking care of the husband who's also working. Sometimes you might be taking care of your parents, because as you know, in the family setting, when you have parents who are unwell, it's the women in the family who take the burden of care. The man might bring a check, maybe. He might pop around and, you know, bring some food every now and again. But it's the women who do the heavy lifting. So there's this constant sort of negotiation of how you manage your academic life and responsibilities, and how you attend to your family responsibilities. And one of the things that is really crucial to advancing in academic life is time. Time is a crucial resource, it's what we call a symbolic resource. If you don't have the time, you're not going to progress. Because you need the time to do the research, you need time to read, you need time to write, you need time to make all those corrections that reviewers might say you need to do in order to get that paper published. And so if you compare yourself to, say, somebody who has 16 hours to spare a day to do their work, and you have 4 hours a day to do your work, you can just do the math. Over a 5-year period, the person who is time rich is going to progress, and the person who is time poor is not going to progress, however intelligent they are.